Hello everyone, and welcome back to Niche. And oh boy, you guys. Oh boy. So, last time we evacuated our island very, very quickly. It was pretty much an emergency because we were running out of food. And we've come to this island, and we discovered that not only is it the killer island, as you can see by these red, the red tiles here, but it's also a jungle. And I'm more than slightly terrified of what we might find. I don't see anything immediately, but I'm quite afraid of what we might find. I see quite a few of these plants here at least, which is a good sign. But I don't know what else could be lurking in this grass. So, I'm going to immediately get these guys nested. Immediately. Because these guys are all pregnant. And there is a leech, which I'm hoping will not come and bother us, and I don't hear anything scary just yet. And then, oh no. And he has a leech. So we're gonna have to leave him for a turn because we don't have anybody with moves near him. Oh gosh. So first things first, let's get that leech off. And that will give us some nice food. And then immediately, so we wanted to breed Rokirta and Mara, I believe. Yeah, they were going to be at the start of our defender line. So the first thing we want to do, and I'm going to listen. I don't hear anything scary just yet. The first thing I want to do is I'm going to get Mara over here. And I'm going to bring Rokirta up here and breed them. And I'm going to listen again. I don't hear anything still. And she has a leech. So we're going to come over here. There are a lot of leeches, it seems. And I'm going to gather some of this regrowing grass. I'm going to... Oh, wait. Was it Mara? Oh. I think it was Mara we wanted to breed. Oh, and we didn't get her in an... Oh, gosh. I'm so flustered, you guys. Ooh. And I don't want... Oh, I don't want her by the sea either. Oh, goodness. I'm just fumbling around now. This is not a good thing. But we had several babies. We had all males. Oh, my gosh. All males. Are you kidding me? We did have Kunu, though. Kunu has the claw, and Kunu seems like the beginning of potentially a good defender line, except he does not have the horns. I want to get those horns in immediately. Above all... No, I don't want the big nose. I want to leave Poison Fang. I'm going to put that back. There we go. And then I think what we want to mutate in also is the ears, because we have some that don't have the ears, the big ears. So we're going to start a new day again. Do I hear anything? So far, so good. And you guys, the one thing I want to say is if we die off here, the series is going to go on hiatus just for a little bit until we can actually... Here, let me breed these guys. Until the new update comes out. Because once the new update comes out, it'll be a... the new update is supposed to come out this month, basically. And so I don't think we'll have time to start much more of a new series in the meantime. And I'm going to give you... Actually, I'm going to move Kirkunu here, and I'm going to put her in this nest. And let's move... I want to move Kunu. I'm going to put Kunu up here for now. And I think I'm going to destroy this nest. And in the meantime, I'm going to have Mare, who is about ready to pass away as it is. Venture a little ways this way. So we are losing Mare, but I want to start getting our defenders bred up, because as far as I know, there can be some very scary carnivores that spawn here, as well as the apes. So we want some creatures that are more capable of evading the apes, and I think we want to leave some of the grass as well, because I'm pretty sure we may get a boost for hiding in grass. I just want to see. I'm going to move him. Oh, well. I don't want to move him up here because that's, this stuff removes all stealth. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna start a new day. We've lost one of our creatures. So far, so good. We're not dead yet. Kunu, I'm going to mark him in blue because he's going to be one of our breeding creatures. I'm going to bring Kunu over here, and I'm actually going to put Kunu so he has color camo. He has color camouflage. And he has distasteful appearance because of the warning dot, so he also has color camouflage. What if we come over here? He has... because he's hiding in cover. Okay, so having some grass is good. So I'm going to try to remove only this regrowing grass if I can. We're probably going to make trails through the island as opposed to actual... actually clearing everything. So what I'm going to do... I'm going to move Mara here. And then I'm going to put Rokirta here. Might as well have him roll in mud, but then he's also going to breed, and then she's going to build a nest, and I'm going to put, she has 4 camouflage, so that's good. I'm going to put her there. Vonkir, how are your genetics, buddy? He's almost a perfect creature for the jungle, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have him come explore up this way. He is a perfect creature for the jungle, I'm pretty sure. And I don't hear anything just yet. So now we have to wait for some of these males to grow up as well. Also, so who has F and G, C and B? I'm going to breed these guys once he's old enough, which should be soon. Hopefully very soon. And I'm going to bring Kosi over here, I think. Because they have the same immunity, but she has the spike body. So I want to start getting her some children as well. And she may pass away. Both of these females are going to pass away pretty soon. We have some defender females over here. In fact, I'm going to put Lenare over here. And I'm actually going to destroy some of these nests. I think. Because we want to keep them. Okay, we're going to check again. So we haven't been, we need to gather some food. So, oh my, Taro, okay. Interesting, so he is stripey. How did he get stripes? How did, I guess, oh no, he has stripes and warning dots, right? Was it? No, that's Rokirta who I have, hang on. I wanna click you. Taro, so he got, how did you get double stripes? Stripes, oh, I guess they do both have stripes. So he will probably have good camouflage, but he is probably not someone we want to breed. So we'll probably have him start gathering some food. And then we have Rihanna, who got the antlers, which is good. How does she compare to... Okay, they have similar immunity, but not quite the same. Oh, there is a nest, which is excellent. And then Roducro... I'm going to bring him down here. I'm going to put Kirku here. I'm going to destroy this nest. And, oh, we need to start getting food soon. I'm going to bring Mara over here, breed, and then make a nest. I don't want to make a nest. I kind of don't want to make a nest. Oh, gosh. I don't like being by the sea because that's where we get leeches. And then Duke is pretty interesting as well. Potentially a good creature. I'm going to have you... I don't hear anything scary. So I'm going to have you... Oh, you can't... Oh, she's too young. So we'll have... What we'll do is we'll have Kirkuku collect. And then we'll lick... Great. I did not realize that was a thing. Okay. Oh, brilliant. I've doomed us all. How are... Gosh, we're gonna lose our female. What about... Oh boy, I don't want that spike body completely in there. We're gonna lose... Oh boy. We need to find a healing fruit immediately. We have a defender line starting. I'm going to come up here and collect. I'm going to actually have Mara scout just a little bit. I don't hear anything yet. You're gonna have to gather some more fruit. You're gonna have to gather some more fruit. I'm gonna have you, because you're gonna pass away this turn. Come up this way. Do we smell healing fruit? No. We can't hear it. I mean, you can't hear plants. Oh boy, you guys. I done bad. Yep, she's going to pass away. Dang it. Oh my gosh, you guys. I don't hear anything at least, which is good. So we're going to have to make do with our defender females, trying to start a line with them. So we have C and G. Is that the same? No. What about... Oh boy. Cuckoo? No. Where is... Okay. They have the same immunity. They have totally different... So... Oh, no. That's Kosi, though. Oh, Kosi's gonna... We have to breed with Mara. Mara is gonna be our only adult female. Well, technically we could. Do we have any... Spike body. Do we have any females that don't have spike body? It's only Mara. So Mara's going to have to try and... I think we have enough creatures for our defender line. Mara's going to have to try and breed with one of our males. None of whom have very good immunity options. Wait. None of them have good immunity options for her. Oh gosh, this is hard. I'm going to start a new day. Alright. Who has... Okay. So lean body, double lean body. You're too young to breed. You have spike body. So I'm going to bring Vonkir here. I think Vonkir is our best option. And I'm going to breed them. And then I'm actually going to have Vonkir do the collecting. Because we can lick him off. And he won't... he will not... damage us. We don't want to have the spike body for our collectors, because this fruit leaves the scent on them and we want to be able to lick it off without taking damage. That was my mistake, as I forgot that. So Kunu, on the other hand, okay, I want to see, do we have... We do! Okay, Seiko. Kunu and Seiko can breed once they get there. So I'm going to put her on Alpha. I'm going to move Duke this way. In fact... No, they have the same immunity. And then I'm going to put Kunu. I'm going to bring Kunu down here. And what about Kirduk? I'm actually going to destroy that nest and this nest too, because we're not going to be using them just yet. And then I'm going to have Rokirta go this way. All right. And then Kuk here. I'm going to clear... We're going to have an area that is clear, but then I want to have an area that's not as clear as well. I want to have grass that we can hide in, clumps of grass where we can go if we get into trouble. So, Ducro here is going to start coming this way. Oh, I'm going to put him up on a stump so he can see really far. I'm going to start moving him towards this plant because he can be a collector because he's not spiky. So we want to start moving a colony this way towards this plant as well. And then Kunu, we're going to breed these guys. I'm going to move Duke. I'm going to start moving everyone who we're not going to be using for breeding to the more dangerous areas, because if they do get killed off faster, we can clean him up. If they do get killed off faster, at least they won't be eating all the food. So let's see. Alright, I think I'm going to go ahead and start a new day. The food supplies are dwindling. Digger's paw would be nice to have. There's Krabbits as well. There's a leech. Oh, you can hear into the water. And I'm pretty sure the water-breathing plants are broken at the moment. So I'm actually going to move here. And then I'm going to put Rokirta up on the stump. And then I'm going to start clearing a bit of a path this way. We want to be able to move. If not, clear everything. We want to have paths. And then Kukir has the same genetics. Okay. So it's going to be Seiko... and Kunu, who have different genetics. And then we've had, the melanism can help because black helps with color camouflage in the jungle. And then Von Kier is the one, okay, we're breeding them. And then Von Kier can gather and we can lick. And we can do that. And then Kukir is going to destroy these nests because we're not going to need them. Oh goodness, we have a leech. I want to get these guys off the beach as well. So I'm going to move Kierduke. I don't think we're going to be using him for breeding. And then I'm going to move these guys up and away from the beach. There we go. And I want to listen. Do I hear anything? I don't hear anything just yet. Let's go ahead and start a new day. Food supplies are dwindling. Oh good, we got rains though. We have rain and that will make sure everything regrows. So now we have Kook here, who we definitely want to breed him. He's going to be the founding male for our, he probably will be the founding male for our non-warrior line. So I'm going to bring him down here. And I'm going to put her here, and then we'll breed them, and then she can lick him. And there we go. I don't see anything just yet. We're not dead. That's a start. And let's see. So Seiko, we do want... I'm going to bring Seiko up here and Kunu up here. And then I'm going to clear the area around here. Because I also want these guys to be able to continue moving this way. Oop. Here we go. And then Roducro is going to be a collector. Do we hear anything? Oh, no. 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 Please, no. Oh, bad news bears. Very, very bad news bears. How high is your attack? Only 3. Brilliant. We want to be very, very careful. Because that guy's coming for us. We're probably going to try and lead him off into the jungle if we can. And then I'm not going to have you clear the grass. I am going to move you here. You can clear that grass. And then Kook here, how strong are you? 5, so not enough. It should be, I think, but it's not for whatever reason. We need at least 6, and because why is it that you don't have enough attack? Or not Kunu, not Rokuta, Kook here. What is it you're missing? So we have the strength from the antlers, we have the strength from the body, we only have 1 claw. We need full on, like, Rokirta would be the only one capable of defending, I think, and even so, he doesn't have the antlers. I think he only has 6. So, I'm gonna go ahead and start a new day. We're running dangerously low on food. And where is he going? Okay, I want to see, though. He is able to reach them. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna lick. Do we hear anything else? We wanna move out of his reach. I think he's focused this way, though, which is not good because he's coming towards the main nest. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring Roducro up here. Duke is gonna start clearing a path so that we have somewhere to escape to. And we're gonna come up this way. We want to be out of the reach of it. And then Taro is going to stand in this step over here because we want to draw the attention away from the nests. We don't want this group here getting caught by that ape. So we're going to try and draw attention away from it. And in fact, oops, I think he's focused on the nest. So he can't reach any of our creatures now. We have some time to see what he's going to do. And I'm going to listen again. I don't hear anybody up here, which is good. And let's see. We are disturbingly low on food, though. We might... Oh, it sounds awful. We might have to start sacrificing some of our creatures to the monkeys. Or the apes. They're technically apes. Okay, so... Miisla, how are your genetics? You have almost perfect genetics, and are you... Okay. I think we're gonna breed Miisla and Kukir. We're gonna do that. And then Taro is going to come this way. There is a leech on the way, I think. We're gonna breed, and then we'll lick. And a Kukir. I'm gonna bring... Ooh, we don't want him in there. That way, we're gonna bring him up here. And then these guys, I think, are gonna make their way further into the grass. Because if they're in the grass, that'll make it harder for them to be seen. So we're gonna start a new day. Oh gosh. Okay, so he did come directly towards Taro. Now. That's not... I want Rihanna. How strong... She can't attack. She doesn't have enough strength to attack. But I'm gonna leave these two here to block the way because they're spiky body. And they're not gonna be used for breeding, so it sounds awful. But we're gonna keep these guys moving into the jungle. And the ape won't be able to reach them this time. We can gather from this. And then Rodukro is gonna start making a path this way. And these guys are now both adults. And I'm gonna put, oh gosh, if we want anyone to lose health from food, we're gonna have to choose, I think. Oh boy. So we have Kukir and Miisla, who are genetically acceptable, and then Mara and Vonkir. I think what we're gonna do too is, I'm gonna leave those guys here, but we're gonna actually, since we know, I think we have the right creatures too. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna destroy these nests, and then I'm gonna move her here. She can disguise her scent or whatever for 3 days. And then Roduke is also genetically, well, what's yours? No, you have that. That would be bad. So we're gonna bring Kukir down here, and these two will be our next breeding pair. But until then, we're not gonna breed them. We're just gonna breed these guys. And we'll clear away this grass and this grass, the regrowing grass, because that's always useful for nesting material. And then we can clear this grass. And clear this grass. I'm gonna put these guys on Omega, because out of everyone, we aren't gonna have enough food, so we have to decide which creatures are not gonna be able to, which one. So I think I'm gonna put Rokirta on Omega. And Kukir, wait. Siko and Kunu. Yeah, it was Kunu. So Kukir, how much strength do you have? 5. Still just 5. Kukir, I'm gonna bring you up here and put you on Omega because we're not gonna be breeding him. And Mara, I'm sorry, I'm gonna put you on Omega because I don't think we're gonna be breeding you. You're gonna come over here. And Kirkuku is not gonna be bred, and he's not a full-fledged gatherer like Vonkir. Vonkir, I'm gonna put on Alpha because I don't want him to end up dying. I want him to be able to continue to gather this plant. But Kirkuku we could replace because he's spiky body, so he can't be a collector, and we could have somebody else here to groom the scent off of Vonkir. Oh gosh, this is gonna be a very brutal tribe, you guys. I'm gonna warn you right now. And let's listen. Still just the one ape, I'm pretty sure. So let's see. I'm gonna come back this way. And you know what? Rokirta's gonna come in here and attack. and attack the ape and see if he can do anything. He at least has a spike body, so, but because he's an Omega, I think he's going to do what everything he can to defend his tribe because there's no one else who can. So, and then I'm going to actually send Kukir. Can we send Kukir? We can move Rihanna around, and then we can move Taro, and we can move Kukir here. I'll clear away that grass. And I have a feeling this ape is going to attack Rokirta, but we'll see. So that should at least handle the food situation. It sounds so awful. And then are you going to be... You're a... Yes, you are a full-fledged runner or gatherer. So we want you on Alpha because you're going to be a good gatherer. And we want... We have one other good gatherer too, which is Roducro, that we want... I'm going to leave... I'm going to put the creatures that are all on Omega. These guys are okay. I'm going to put them all on Orange so we know. And those are the ones that we're going to be sending into the most danger, which sounds awful, but if these apes attack the creatures that we need, then their genetics are going to suffer. Our tribe could die out because we won't have any good genetics and all of our creatures will get wiped out. So we have to preserve the ones that have the best genetics, which sounds absolutely awful, but it's going to be a very brutal, very unforgiving world for these guys. We've sent them into grave danger. So let's... Oh, I'm going to start needing to... Okay, we're good. I'm actually going to bring Kukir... Nope. Oh, Kukir did get a leech. Okay, and then I'm going to bring Vonkir. And there's another. That was brilliant. Kukir, you're one of our breeding creatures. Why? That was a very bad idea. I apologize. I did not realize there was going to be another leech so close. Well, we're just going to have to start a new day. And we have to get this leech off. Thankfully, I don't think it's... gonna be that awful, so we're gonna get him away from the water, and we'll have Vonkir come gather, and then we'll groom him. And it didn't actually kill him; it did attack him though. But we can now use all of our attack, and we've actually done 10 days worth of damage. Well, I think it probably got some from attacking him as well because he has the spike body. So I'm pretty sure we are going to lose him next time. Oh, and I forgot about that. That's why we don't gather with these creatures. So let's gather that, and then we're going to scoot over here. We're going to gather these, and then scoot up here, and then I'm going to clear this path towards this area. And do we hear anything else? So far, just the one ape. We may still be able to do this. And I'm actually going to bring Kunu over this way because I want to put Seiko right here. And we'll breed and make another nest. And we have a pretty good defender. She's got everything but the horns and she has one claw. So if we come up against carnivores, she'd be okay. Oh, wait. Why is she so much... I guess, no, she doesn't have horns and she doesn't have another claw. That's why she only has four. So possibly, we'll see. And then, Taro, do these guys, they have the same genetics. I think, though, because if we bring him up here, he does not get any color camouflage, whereas these guys get color camouflage. So I think Taro is not going to be a breeding creature. I'm going to put him on... just on beta. Oh no, but he's going to be a good collector, so we want to leave him on alpha. So I'm going to scoot him this way. And then these are going to be our breeding creatures. We don't want him on blue though. Blue is for breeding. And then Roduk. Unfortunately, there's no one who can breed with Roduk, so I'm going to put him on Omega. He is... No, he would actually... He'll be a good collector though. So we're going to scoot Roduk this way. And let's go ahead and we'll start a new day. We don't have enough food either. This is very bad. Oh my gosh. That escalated quickly. Wait, what? Wait, what? 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 You have digger paw. Please.
We don't have the food. Dang it, why?
Why? Okay. Quickly, quickly. We need... Oh, we really need that creature to join our tribe. And now it's back. Oh, Kirduk, we really need... Because Claw and Digger Paw is what we really need. Because if we look, we have... Well, we can't see it now, but we have found some of the roots. Now, the camouflage and everything would be awful, so we'd have to keep this creature absolutely away from the apes. But I wonder if... Maybe it'll come this way. No? Maybe not. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna bring Roducro up here. Oh no, don't stand by the ape. You're gonna get yourself killed. Okay, oh, we gotta try and get that creature to join us. Okay, so, Lako, how are you? Why are you... Oh, you probably took damage from not eating because you're just a beta. Okay, so I really want a creature that has the horns. Oh gosh, I really need a creature that has horns. Or double claw. Even double claw would suffice. But we'll go ahead. Who is smelly? We need to lick you off. And then Kook here. Why are you injured? Why are you injured? We really need to get a group off to this this plant as well. So, since Roduk... Oh, hey, hey, maybe. Oh, it'd be so dangerous, though. I'm gonna bring, oh gosh. I'm gonna do it. We need, oh yes! We need to be able to get more food. Even if it's gonna, oh, it's gonna do so much harm to the tribe this time though. Oh gosh. Everybody is slowly dying of starvation, and I really can't do much to stop it. So, we're just gonna have to let them take damage, you guys. Okay, so, Kirduk is so old too, oh gosh. I want to, oh boy. Let's try and at least this, made this plant regrow. I'm gonna have you gather from it, even though you're spiky. Let's see. Let's go up here. Gather from that. And then at least- Yes, 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 yes! Oh, she's weakened, but nevertheless! Okay, she's gonna be a breeding creature. She's gonna go on Alpha. I'm gonna actually take these guys off of Alpha. Only the creatures we absolutely need for breeding are going to be on Alpha. So, where is our... So, our male is here, and we have Lacerae. And they have some overlapping immunity, but if necessary, we could breed them. And then a Kirduk. I kind of want to breed Kirduk to try and get that digger paw, but I'm not sure that would be a good idea. So, quickly, we will gather some more of this food. Kook here is going to die soon, though. And we can't even gather from that. So what I think I'm gonna do is come over here, and then come over here, because what I wanna do is go boink, and then flee. And flee as far away as we can get. And Lako is gonna go on Omega because we now have a female that will replace her for breeding purposes. Holy cow, okay. Oh boy, you guys. That's a smelling ape. And it has probably scented these guys by now, and I can only hope that their stinky tail will deter it. As for the others, though, I can't say. Or as for poor Lako caught in this plant, I think she's kind of doomed. Because we don't have the means to deal with this right now. So, with that said, we're gonna have to breed again. I'm gonna put Kirtanu up here, and then we're gonna move here, and we'll breed them again. And then, is there anything else you can do, buddy? I'm not so sure there is. That was probably a very poor decision, seeing as you're not actually going to help us that much. Oh boy, you guys. So, let's see. I'm gonna bring these guys down here, too. And hopefully... they will help deter this creature, this ape. And we're gonna have to start a new day. We're gonna have some creatures that are injured by starvation. Oh boy. And did the smelling ape leave? No, it's still right there. We just can't see it anymore. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come up, I'm gonna gather, and then Taro is going to lick that one, and I hope, hopefully the ape will not attack him because he has that stinky, stinky tail, and hopefully that will deter the smelling ape. Cure Duke, I'm sorry. I probably shouldn't have invited you into the tribe, but it seemed like a good decision. It was probably actually a very bad decision, though. I'm gonna breed these guys again because I'm trying to get another male that, because I think these guys have, yeah, they have 4 immunity genes between the two of them. So I'm hoping we'll get one that has none in common at all. And on Amari, I'm gonna put on Omega. I have to put her on Omega, you guys. I'm sorry. I'm gonna put Cure Duke here. Gather, gather. Come over here, gather. And come back up here. Oh boy, you guys. And then we're gonna have to gather some more fruit, and we can gather this regrowing grass, and then cook here. Okay, these guys are finally able to breed. So even though we don't have that much food, we kinda have to do this, because we need to get a good line of runner leg creatures to gather established. So, and then you can come up here. There's actually nothing to gather, so I'm gonna start doing this. And do we hear anything up here? Nope, there's 2 apes so far. Oh gosh, you guys, this could be the end of the tribe. We could be seeing the final days. And I have gone overtime, so we're gonna go ahead and leave off the episode here for now. But I will see you guys next time, and until then, this is Jay, over and out.